The oil and gas value chain is broadly divided into two segments: upstream for the discovery and production of crude oil and natural gas, and downstream for refinement and sales of the end products. Each is a big industry of its own. Due to the complexity of each segment, most companies focus on one, though major oil and gas companies are fully integrated across the value chain. Let's start with upstream. The world has a surface area of 200 million square miles. How can oil companies know where oil and gas reserves are? It starts with the exploration phase. Explorations can be onshore or offshore, and the objective here is not to find oil or gas, but to narrow down the search area by identifying potential reservoirs that might host oil and gas. Have you ever seen someone selecting a watermelon by tapping on it and listening for a hollow sound to see how ripe it is? Oil and gas exploration process is similar to that, just more expensive. A lot more expensive. The exploratory process starts with seismic surveys of basins to scan below the surface and identify potential reservoir targets. Seismic surveys use sound waves, akin to the watermelon tapping and listening method, to create images of subsurface rock layers. The sound waves, generated by a loud bang, like the detonation of dynamite in a hole dug in the ground, or from an air gun in the water, travel through the earth and are partially reflected by each rock boundary back to the surface. Geophones placed at the surface record the reflections, which are then digitized and analyzed by geophysicists to identify potential rock formations that could lead to oil and gas accumulations. In addition to seismic surveys, companies also conduct regional studies to see if there are discovered reserves in neighboring countries with similar geographies. This would increase the probability of discovering reserves in the basin under exploration. Based on the results of seismic surveys and regional studies, companies will decide to proceed to drilling exploratory wells, which are typically 5 inches wide, with a depth ranging from a few hundred feet to 20,000 feet. Next, samples are collected from the drilled wells and tested, in attempts to confirm the presence of a reservoir and its properties in terms of volume and mobility, that is, how easily the reservoir will flow. Tests are used to create 3D models of the reservoir and to identify the depth of different layers of gas, oil, and water. This is an important step because drilling to extract oil and gas is a delicate operation, and mistakes can be economically catastrophic. Even with the most advanced tests and models, exploration is always a risky bet. Companies can spend millions drilling to find an empty well, or wells that are not commercially recoverable with existing technologies. With modern seismic survey technologies, the chances of finding oil or gas is less than 20%.